David Letterman back in the headlines this morning, 1 year after leaving his show.
The legendary comedian humoring us with his take on the current landscape of late night TV and the race for the White House, all in an exclusive interview with Tom Brokaw, who's here with us now. Tom, always a pleasure.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to be here. I caught up with Dave actually back in his hometown of Indianapolis. He's a race car team owner, and he was there for the Indy 500, but he also took me on a nostalgic look at his earlier life, and he didn't hold back on sharing what's on his mind these days, including some regrets for the sacrifices that he made for his late night show.
Like, I delayed having a family because I thought it would be a distraction from my show. Well, so what? It's just a TV show. It's just an hour of colorful images. You know, it's not like you were bringing the world to America's living room. I wasn't even doing that. I was, hey kids, how you doing? And that, you know, that's all I had.
There are two things, two man-made things that are visible from 50 miles up. One, of course, is the Great Wall of China, and the other, Donald Trump's hair. That's right.
It's now been a year since David Letterman walked away from the stage where he entertained America every night.
Donald Trump, Hillary, Bernie Sanders. There are times when you just say, God, I'd like to be on tonight. I'd like to be talking about this.
Well, you know, I understand that he's repugnant to people, but you tell me the men putting together the Constitution, witnessing this election, wouldn't they have just said, that's part of the way we set it up. Good luck.
You're absolutely right. He didn't cheat by
right,
getting the nomination.
There's nothing illegal going on. It's just he's despicable.
He is speaking his mind after a 33-year, 6,000-show career.
Thank you very much.
Do you miss every night?
No. I don't. And it's interesting. I thought for sure I would. And then the first day of Stephen's show, when he went on the air, an energy left me, and I felt like, you know, that's not my problem anymore. I couldn't care less about late night television. I'm happy.
Well, I think America wants to know, having seen you all those years on television, now seeing you occasionally, what's living in that beard? I mean, is it nesting something there, or is it?
Likely. we have a guy from Orkin coming out here later. I always told myself, when the show goes away, I will stop shaving. I had to shave every day from 20 till I was 68, roughly, every day. And I got so sick and tired of it.
David also told me that there was one thing that would make him get rid of that beard, but unfortunately, it didn't happen. He wanted to win the 100th running of the Indy 500, but they didn't get there. So
keep that beard on for a
little
longer.
He's a man very much at ease with who he is at this point.
Sure seems like it.
Tom, thanks so much. Always good to see you. And you can see Tom's entire report on David Letterman and much, much more this Sunday night on Assignment. That's at 7, 6 Central, 10 Pacific, right here, of course, on NBC.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.